I played Jerry Mulligan, who's a GI, mid-20s, who doesn't want to go home to the U.S. He stays in Paris. He falls in love with the city. He sees this beautiful girl the first day. He's enamored with her. He sketches her. All of a sudden, he sees her 2 weeks later at a ballet class, at an audition, and he follows her around because he can't believe that he got so lucky to meet her again. Falls in love with her, love at first sight, and will do kind of anything to try and woo her. I think there's a bit of war guilt for him. You know, he survived. His friends didn't. And he kind of carries them on his shoulders. So everything he does is to its fullest, to honor them, because they couldn't pursue their loves. They couldn't pursue their passions. So he's kind of doing it for them. And that brings a lot of kind of resolution for him and his character. So, and then there's just the struggle and trying to be with the one that you love who has previous obligations. Leanne and I have been through 3 premieres of this show now, and we've got a lot of shows under our belt, a lot of rehearsal under our belt, and I think that lends itself to a lot of sense of play. We can do different things every night because we know the realm of the possibilities. We've done so much together, so we feel safe enough to challenge ourselves, is basically what I'm trying to say. I think the toughest would probably be the ballet at the very end, because you've done a whole show and then at the very end you have to do a 15-minute ballet. So that's kind of the moment where you feel like you're at your limit, but you've got that music that's pumping from the orchestra pit, and you can't help but dance. So it kind of solves itself.
My name's Hayden Oakley. I play Henri Borel in American in Paris.
And I'm David Seadon-Young, and I play Adam in American in Paris.
Henri is more of a traditional suitor for Lise. He's French. He is very much in love with theatre and cabaret, and has a yearning for that. And I think there's a sense of duty in his love for Lise rather than anything passionate, really. So that's kind of Henri. What about Adam? Yeah.
Adam is a writer, a struggling writer. He was a soldier in the war. That's where the bond with Jerry comes from. He knew Henri before via cabaret acts, I'd imagine. And he's a struggling writer. He's very much the heart of the piece. He narrates throughout. He has a great rapport with the audience, which is what was so exciting for me. About the part, but yeah, and he's a wonderful, warm character who is also in love with Lise, but doesn't quite.
How did you get cast in it? Lovely.
So no, just went against the grain with that one. What always gets me, and when I saw the show in New York, especially with a couple of them, Can't Take That Away From Me was one of them. Yep. You are constantly surprised by the amount of work that this man created before, I think it was 36 or 38. It was one of 36 or 38, which is when he sadly died. The amount of work that is there. And I go to see a show and someone tells me, oh, there's a bit of Gershwin music in it. And I'm constantly surprised by what music and how much music I actually know, which is in itself quite special.
I think it's always incredible the amount of ways that the songs can be done. And the fact that even for this show, they've been reorchestrated and repackaged, you know, for the show. And yet they still feel incredible with our amazing orchestra and sung by different voices. And, you know, even in the run and the rehearsals we've had up to this evening, we've added new lines and new harmonies and all those. And it never seems to be anything that's been stapled onto it. It always seems to be something that just works. I think that's something to do with the music, you know, and the Gershwin estate being good enough to let us try things like that and in order to make it our own. I think that's what makes the Gershwin music so great, is that you can make it your own. Like we have.
Yes.
Like you have, Dave.
Like you have.
When I saw the show on Broadway in September last year, I was blown away by the design, by Bob's design, which is just the word I came away with was classy, and the whole thing is, it's hard to describe actually. I think it's beautiful and very simple. There's not huge bits of set, but what we do have is, with Chris's choreography, is balletic, the way it's choreographed around the stage. The lights, the stairway number that Henri does is just amazing, with bits of the Chrysler building almost that you can see. It's classy and beautiful, and it's an honour to be on the stage with it. It really is.
When I saw it, it was apparent that the class of the design, the set and the design, is married with the Gershwin music and with the choreography. Each and every single one of those details is just stunning, which is, when they come together, it's just really rather special.
Talking about special, what is most special about bringing this production specifically home to the heart of the West End?
I think it's very special for, on a personal reason, I think, for Chris and for Leanne, definitely. I mean, Leanne is born in Bath and had done it in Paris and had done it on Broadway. I think she was very, very excited about bringing it here, as was Chris, because he has such an affiliation with the, you know, Royal Ballet here, and I think they were all very, very much looking forward to seeing what the show really, really had to offer.